This is an unclimbed active ice volcano just above Antarctica. The goal for this National Geographic assignment is to make the first ascent with a team of scientists and confirm with our own eyes if there's actually lava inside the crater.
Sorry, guys.
Down to nothing.
We're working on this tonight.
Masks up.
The sailing on this was no joke. The Southern Ocean, the tail end of the Drake Passage, truly some of the toughest seas on Earth.
I know that when Renan asks me to come on a shoot, that it is going to be simultaneously the most miserable I will ever be, but also it will take me to some of the most beautiful places and I will have some of the most incredible experiences of my life.
This is the zone of points.
On the satellite, volcano scientists somehow discovered this thermal anomaly in the South Sandwich Islands in the far southern Atlantic Ocean. What looked like a rare lava lake on top of this crazy unclimbed volcano.
Our mission is to discover whether there is a lava lake at the top of Mount Michael, and then what can we do to harness this to understand something new about how volcanoes erupt that we can then take and apply to other volcanoes around the world that threaten communities.
With the volcano.
Yeah. Are you excited?
Yeah, I'm excited. And you?
I'm very excited. Yeah. This is going to be awesome.
This isn't cool.
Oh, it's day one in the Southern Ocean. Half the scientists lost their lunch within the first hour. Hi, nice to meet you. Let me film you vomiting at close range with high resolution cameras.
If you think of the Drake Passage being one of the most dangerous, treacherous pieces of water on the planet, the Drake would have looked like a teddy bear's picnic compared to the South Sandwich.
The lesson I once heard for assignments that kind of stuck with me was that no matter how hard the conditions, you try to get one usable, publishable A-frame every single day. So I'm trying. Finally seeing the cauldron of Mount Michael.
That looks mean.
We're setting up a UV camera to measure the SO2 flux. The conditions are just perfect. We'll just go ahead and start doing some measurements.
With scientific permit, we'll be the first to camp on Saunders Island. But it involves landing in dry suits and ferrying all of our gear above the shore so we don't disturb the wildlife. It's an exhausting process, but at least we'll have a nice place to camp.
The wind's blowing around, it just kind of puts you on edge when the wind is blowing like that. You kind of start with a certain amount of life force. There were some big percentage points lost the last couple days because people are just so excited. And they're so passionate about the science, but...
So we're not going tomorrow.
Ah, sad. But if
there's anything like... I'm sad, because, you know, I really want to get
back
on.
He's going to go until he collapses.
But if there's anything like this, then...
It's a bad situation.
It's sensible.
Is it,
a bit more.
Sorry.
We're honestly being shredded alive on this island. We discovered the snow was too acidic to melt for water. Not only 100 mile an hour gusts, but wind that carries needles of black lava rock pelting everything.
Any sort of movement would not be advisable.
It's a 24-hour watch just to keep camp alive. The usually understated Captain Ben says there's a megastorm on the way, and we have to be off the island within the next 24 hours.
Copy all that, Ben. Thank you.
Yeah.
That just makes me want to cry.
It's gonna be tough.
So it's now or never for the first ascent of Mount Michael, and to stay on top long enough to do meaningful science and confirm the lava lake. Climbing inside the poisonous sulfuric acid of the volcano's plume, with heat holes underneath creating crevasses that you don't even know the shape and size, zero visibility, often stuck for hours in a single position, not knowing if we can go up or down or what kind of scary holes we're gonna fall into. Summit crater rim, the scientists carrying twice the weight in all their equipment.
Oh, look at that. It's everywhere I want to be right now in the world.
I'm so happy. It's so beautiful. Like, this is the majesty of the nature.
For me, at this point, true creativity and exploration, they're deeply connected to Earth and those fighting to understand it.
Yeah. Emma's up there, one axe, one hand on this pelican case with tubes coming out of it. Scientific instrument out of a sci-fi movie.
Never stop exploring and never stop measuring.
Never stop measuring.